Callie here. Welcome to another video. And today I'm going to be giving you guys 5 tips on how you can earn a lot more money in Bloxburg. Now, these tips seem pretty simple to me. I've been seeing a lot of comments asking how I get so much money and asking about boosting moods and so many other little things that can really, really help you make a lot more money, because even though you work, I know a lot of people are new to Bloxburg. Now it's getting a lot more popular, and so a lot more people are joining and not knowing what they can do to be able to earn a lot more money. And it's little things that can help you. So I'm going to give you guys some tips. These are things that I do, or things that I know my friends do and other people do that help them. And I know that it'll be able to help you. So let's get started. I just love seeing my delivery plaque up here. All right, anyway, the first tip that can help you earn a lot more money is to buy the Excellent Employee Game Pass. I know it's 300 Robux, which is kind of a lot. And I think this is the main reason why I've been able to earn so much money and so little time, because with the Excellent Employee Game Pass, it doubles the amount of money you make and it doubles the amount of XP you get. So at pizza delivery, you'll get like 2 points per person, but when you have Excellent Employee Game Pass, you get 4 per person, which helps you level up faster, which is so good. The second tip is to boost your moods. You need to make sure all of your moods are at 100% before you start working, because the higher your moods are, the more money you get. For example, when I work with great moods at pizza delivery, I make about $500 more than I would if my moods were super low. You'll see here in my clip where I was at a super low mood and I made I'm on level 50, so it still seems like a lot, but then when you see I boost my moods and then I start working there, I make about $500 more, which is a big difference from when I have low moods to great moods. And that can make such a difference when you're working for an hour or even 30 minutes. $500 adds up. Also, if you don't have Bloxbux, for me, I use my Robux to buy some Bloxbux so that I don't have to stop at my house to boost my moods. But if you are not able to get Bloxbux, you should create a mood station where you have a bunch of items that can help boost your moods quickly without going into the house and getting stuck like I did in my last video. And maybe get a bed so you can have your energy, some coffee or the bed. The bed will help your energy last longer, but the coffee would be faster to get. The tea for your hunger, a book or a TV. I prefer the book because then my intelligence increases at the same time. And then you can get a shower or a sink or a toilet so that it can help boost your hygiene. And once you have those, you set it up in one place in your plot. And then when you're working, you don't have to get off your bike and then end your shift, because I like to see how long I've worked and chopping it up by ending my shift. I can't really keep track of that. I can, but it'll be more difficult and more work, and I don't want to do that. So that's why I use Bloxbux. But creating a mood station is just as good, because you don't have to get off your bike to boost your moods. Now, the third tip is to work for at least an hour. I say this often because this is what I do every single time I'm on Bloxburg when I'm not filming and I'm just working so that I can level up. I always work for at least an hour, because the longer you work, the more you level up, and the more you level up, the more money you make. People with higher levels make a lot more money than people with lower levels. And if you don't have the motivation to work for an hour, you can go and watch my tips and tricks video on how to work longer, because a lot of people have commented that it helped them work longer, make a lot of money, which I'm happy about, because that means it works for some people. And yeah, And some people in the comments were asking me about the levels, like, how come I don't make as much money as you when I work for an hour? And if you're on like level 5, you're not gonna make as much money as I would since I'm on level 50, you know? Now the fourth tip is work with friends. Now that there's a new friend mood, like when you see, you will see at the top here, you see where my chair is, you'll see a friend symbol. It'll show you which friend is near you. And when you're near your friends, your moods last longer, so they don't go down as quickly as it would if you weren't around your friends. So if you're driving with your friends, a pizza delivery, or working at any other job and you're near your friends, then your moods will last longer and they'll stay higher. And like I said before, the higher your moods are, the more money you'll make. And my last tip is work at a job where you are the highest level and stay there, because higher levels get paid more money. And you want to be able to make a lot of money in a short amount of time. And working at a job where you are at the highest level will get you that. So I'm not going to go and say, man, I need a lot of money, let me go work fisherman. And I'm level 1 at fisherman. I think I tried it once. And I'll probably make like $100 per person, per fish. I don't even know how that job works. And I can work at miner or cashier or delivery person and make up to $3,000 a person, per block, per customer. So that is what I would recommend. I feel like these tips are very simple, but you know, there are a lot of new people who are joining Bloxburg, so you guys who are new may not know. And these are just some tips that can definitely help you earn a lot more money, especially with the leveling up and the boosting your moods. Those are very, very important. Let me know if there are other ways you can make a lot more money. Any more tips that I probably missed, or some tips that I probably don't know myself, because I feel like I'm still new. I don't really do much to explore the different options in Bloxburg besides building and working. So if I missed anything or I don't know anything, let me know in the comments down below. Let me know what helps you and what things you're doing to make a lot more money, so whoever reads the comments can do those too. And thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you next time with a speed build talk through. I did a poll on my community tab and you guys prefer tours first, speed build second, because you guys like to see what the house or whatever I'm building will look like before building it, so that you'll know if you like it or not, which makes sense. So I will start incorporating that into my videos. Anyway, I'll see you next time with another video. Bye.